Like, yeah, I'm basically just touching up on women's clothes all day.
What?
Bro, one of the people that he's worked with got outed for being a pedo.
Like, things I didn't even know was racist. I know.
Today's guest, someone very close to me. I would say about 2 feet away from me right now. Mm-hmm. It's a brand new person in my life. He's a great guy. I don't even know him that well, but I just know that he's a great guy. He starts with an E, ends with a J. Today we got EJ.
Hey, appreciate it.
How you feeling? How you feeling?
I don't know. Sure. I'm pretty fine, actually. I'm not gonna lie.
How do you know? You don't know and then you just feel fine?
I mean, it's a mixture. It's a mixture. That's
what's
all.
Got you feeling not fine?
I mean, this is like my first time on a podcast.
Oh yeah, I was telling her about that. I was like, I don't know if he's gonna be nervous because some people they come in here and they're really nervous.
See, I feel like I'm gonna warm up a little bit.
Oh yeah,
like real
it
quick.
Takes a
it's, gonna,
second,
yeah, it's gonna be real quick. It's gonna be real quick. Don't worry.
I know. Don't let the cameras like get to you, bro.
I know.
It's only three.
I mean, three better than one, I guess.
Yeah, definitely. Definitely. So, what you finna buy a crib?
Yes. Yeah. We're in the process of it right now. Actually, but it's taking forever.
Well, like, here, or, like over there. Where your school is at? In Kennesaw?
Kennesaw.
Yeah.
They're kind of both because there's two campuses for KSU. There's one in Marietta and Kennesaw.
Mm.
But since the major is mainly engineering,
yeah,
it has to be in Marietta. Because, they're like 15 minutes apart, but it doesn't really matter, to be honest.
Because how far is that from here? Like an hour?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. It's like an hour. And with traffic, it's probably like an hour 30.
Oh, yeah.
Or so.
The traffic be
it's
crazy,
bad.
Bro.
It's
That's
bad.
Not too far, though. I know, because, like, did you came here because you left yesterday in the morning. Or no, yeah. You left this morning. No, you left yesterday in the morning?
It was yesterday morning, because I slept over there.
Sheesh.
So.
That drive, like, you don't, that's a
no,
brain dead drive, like.
Dude, bro, while driving here, my back.
Oh,
man, it's just an hour drive, but dude, it's bad. I was up there, like, arching.
Nah, dude, I don't know. Facts, bro. I hate, like, I'd be having to drive a long distance for my job and stuff, and they'd be having me in this van, and, like,
oof.
I'd be like.
What do you even do?
I just, like, I work for her family, and, like, I basically work in their warehouse. And they have, like, stores around Georgia. And, like, on Mondays, I'll, like... So, basically, throughout the week, I'll be, like, splitting orders for each store.
Okay.
And then for their online. And then on Monday, I'll go, like, basically deliver to every store.
Gotcha.
So, it's chill. It's nothing, like, crazy, like, demanding and, like, what's it called? Like, heavy lifting or nothing like that. Like,
okay,
something
just,
like... So, it's chill. Like,
it's just driving a lot? Is that what it is?
It's driving and just, like, basically, like, splitting and counting orders.
Oh, okay. Is it like their own business type
of
thing?
Yeah, it's like their own.
That's
trip.
Cool. That's actually
they like
cool.
Sell women's clothes.
Mm.
Like, yeah, I'm basically just touching up on women's clothes all day.
That's crazy.
Like, it's crazy. I
is
can't
it like
lie.
Their own brand or anything, or is it just like
no?
Just
it's like they like buy off of other vendors, is what they call them.
Okay,
they'll
like
buy in bulk and then they'll sell them in their stores.
Oh, next. So is that like dropshipping? Is that dropshipping?
I don't think it's dropshipping, but
it's like. The vendors are like the middleman from the dropshipping, if that makes sense.
Yeah, okay.
Or
okay.
Or more the middleman, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
But instead of people like straight up ordering from there and getting it, like we're kind of.
Okay, that makes sense. Yeah,
because we sell like Simply Southern and shit. Mm-hmm. Like,
very boutique kind of. Like,
there's a store in downtown here.
Really? That's actually really cool.
Yeah, there's one in downtown. I'm giving like free promo here, but it doesn't matter.
<Not sponsored. laughs>
One in downtown.
Yeah.
One in Buford. One in Jefferson. Carrollton, but like yeah, it's chill. It's like I've worked other jobs and like this is definitely one of those jobs where like it's not as bad as like I've moved people's houses.
Okay.
I worked at Chick-fil-A, I worked at fucking Bojangles.
Dog, you
I worked
moved?
At Yamaha.
I could never move people, but I hate moving with a burning passion.
Bro, I don't know. I hate moving too, bro. I hate it when people like know that I moved back in my day and they like the first person they hit when they're moving is me.
Oh
bro.
My god,
you trying to help
nah.
me move, you trying to help me
nah,
do this
see,
I'm like bro what
no
nah, the reason I don't
that's
do that shit
crazy
anymore.
Nah. You can't even pay me to do it. I genuinely hate it. I don't know how
not
much
moving.
You're getting paid, but I couldn't do
not
it bro.
Moving is ass.
You said you worked at Yamaha, is that like motorcycles?
It's
like
they have a lot of I was in assembly line like putting
ooh.
Like on rope like basically like putting parts on a robot and then like the robot would weld it.
Oh snap. Okay.
And then they had me take a welding test. And then I moved on to welding, which was, like, super easy. I was just, like, fixing shit that the machines weren't doing right.
I heard, like, welders make a lot of money.
Yeah.
Like, an insane amount.
You make more, like, if you're, like, working for, like, a private company.
Mm.
Like, you wouldn't make, like, the peak amount that you would at welding working at Yamaha. Because, like, there's just so many other welders. But if you were, like, welding, let's say, for, like, a school. Like, oh
yeah, nah.
They
there's
would.
No way.
Yeah.
Speaking of Yamaha, I heard you got a motorcycle.
I did. Got a Hayabusa. Some slight.
No way. Some There's no slight. Way.
What you mean, bro? What you mean?
Hayabusa's crazy.
I know, bro. I know, bro. I had to, like, I went through fucking hell to get that bitch to work. Because my dad just let that bitch sit. He Wait, bought
is
it.
Is that actually a Hayabusa though?
Yes, bro. I swear to God. What? Well, after this, we'll go down there and turn it on.
Dog, no way. I thought it was something else. No, I thought you were actually coming. That's crazy.
Yeah, it's like 3100 XR or some shit like that.
Dude.
Yeah. It's like the best of the best.
That's insane, yeah. Bro. I didn't know you had that. I never just seen sitting. It because it was just
it's
always
just covered,
covered up.
Bro. It's just sitting down there like, I don't know, bro. Like a damn old ass candy bike? Bar. Yeah, that's my first
brother.
Bro. I'm looking up videos on YouTube how to fucking ride a bike because I have no idea how to ride a bike,
dude. And like, I had to do a class or something.
I am. I'm about to go to Harley,
yeah,
bro.
Yeah, go ahead, bro. Because there's no way.
That bike is 530 pounds, dude.
Nah,
that shit's heavy.
Nah.
Like I just got used to like the weight.
Really?
Yeah, because no, I would just no. like sit on it. And, like it says to like kind of like get yourself used to the bike, kind of like waddle with it, walk with it, and shit.
Yeah. See, the only thing I've got bike experience is like dirt bikes.
So you know how to ride a bike?
Barely.
You could teach me.
Hell no.
you could go down there and ride that bike.
Nah. I guess that thing would be under me like flipping there, bro. I couldn't. I was a child when I started riding the motorbike, the dirt bike.
Yeah.
In Michigan, we had like a
grew
lot
up in Michigan?
Of
it. Mm.
You did too. What part?
I didn't grow up.
Oh, she was okay. born in Michigan.
My whole family's from there, like okay. Port Huron.
Oh, like, dang, you're on the other side. Okay, I'm like we're kind of like Grand Rapids and stuff like that.
My cousins went to college.
Really? Okay, yeah. Okay. Yeah.
Damn, you came all the way out here.
I don't know why.
That's crazy.
Out of all the places, United States, Georgia. Like, bro.
This shit. I mean, D-gens.
Yeah.
Hella
it wasn't even.
Out here.
It wasn't my choice. So
yeah, that's fair.
It's whatever.
Sure. How do you like Georgia?
Honestly,
wait. When did, okay. How long have you been down here?
I moved down here like I was like 9. All right,
continue with what you were saying then.
Honestly, Georgia is okay, but this like part like Atlanta, hate it.
Atlanta's ass.
Hate it. The traffic's horrible. There's no reason why there should be that many people in that one area. Honestly, but like I'm more of like a rural person. I'm not really a city guy.
Yeah, same.
I hate the city a lot. But if it's like over here, this is nice over here.
Yeah,
it's like a lot
nice
of like
quiet.
Mm-hmm. But other than that.
Yeah, Noonan's kind of like getting kind of ass like Atlanta. Like, I feel like a lot of people from Atlanta are starting to like,
yeah,
like, it'd be a lot
know.
Of traffic.
I'm barely here.
I know. Yeah, like, when you, if you live down here, bro, you would be like,
no, actually, traffic. Peachtree City is busy though.
Peachtree City's ass.
Yeah. See, nah, I gotta like, it gotta be like a rural area.
Yeah, 100%. I'm like that too. Like, I like to be like away from the stuff. Mm. Like, I used to, I think my apartment was like basically in the middle of Noonan and I was close to everything and it was nice, but like, it's just like,
Too
many people, yeah. I'm trying to like live my life. Mm-hmm. I'm not trying to worry about who's getting shot up down the street.
That's
like,
crazy.
Like, my neighborhood was fucking sketch,
That's
bro. I'm
wild.
Not even gonna lie. That shit was crazy goofy, bro. Mm-hmm. But no. Shit, yeah, we'll go down there and turn on the bike after this shit. Yeah, I do want it.
That's crazy.
You might have to teach me, bro.
I couldn't teach you nothing, bro.
I know that. I know that shit's like too much because I put it in first gear and it's already trying to.
Are you serious? Nah, yeah, bro.
It's already trying to go. Like I let go of the clutch a little bit and it's already trying to take off on
crazy.
Me.
That's crazy. Now my dad was about to. He saw a Kawasaki. I think it was either 650 or 400.
Mm.
He where he's in California, and he saw it. He's like, "Oh, I found this bike for sale. I wonder if you wanted it or not." I was like, "Yeah, I was thinking about it," and I sent a message to him recently. But if I get a bike.
Oh,
we're going. Yeah, but you might.
I need to find somebody, bro.
Might have to.
Shit, we'll find one for you, bro.
Yeah,
bro. We'll fucking find one for you, bro. Fuck all the bullshit, bro. Yo, I need a riding partner, bro. Because I swear I'm gonna be out there just alone.
Bro.
I'm gonna just be on the roads out
you
there.
You have the Mustang V's.
It's a 6, bro.
Okay.
I ain't gonna lie to you.
It's okay. Sorry.
It just sounds like a V8.
Hey.
Shit.
That's what
it is, bro.
But I was looking. I was like, dang, because I remember I was asking was wrong fit, and you told me everything like that, but. I had a car, I can't really, you saw my car out there.
The Subaru?
This, yeah, it's not meant so for cruising, but it's all right. It was a gift.
Subaru was all right, I like Subaru. Yeah.
I was a Mitsubishi kid.
Oh.
And I swore against Subarus, that looked at me. I'm in a Subaru.
That's crazy. Mitsubishi to Subaru
but like,
is crazy.
Earlier when I was driving, not driving here, but I was driving somewhere, and I saw like a bunch of cars cruising, because I used to cruise like a bunch of cars, like random people.
Yeah,
like, I used
just to do, together, yeah.
And I tried to like cruise with them, but they wouldn't accept me, bro.
They was not fucking
that shit
with
hurt
Subaru.
My feelings, like for real.
That's
I was like, damn,
crazy.
Like this is my first like ever like economy like boring car. I'm like, dog, this actually hurts. It actually hurts.
Bro's trying to speed up, and they're speeding up with you. Like
that's you crazy. Avoiding me, bro. I was like, dang. So who is this dude back here trying to cruise with us?
Yeah,
this boring ass.
Maybe shitting on Subarus. I can't even lie. People
shitting
on Subarus, bro.
Yeah.
I think I drove. I went to Oregon one time. I had to drive one. Subaru,
really?
Yeah.
It wasn't an upgrade, is it? Was it?
It was a hatchback.
Oh, Was that the Impreza?
I think. I don't even remember, but it was like a hatchback one. I was like, it's like that. It's I heard him wrong over the phone. I thought he said I was going to be driving a Supra. I was like, Supra! And then I get there, there's a Supra. I'm like, oh, hell no. I was like, oh, fuck no.
That's disappointing, actually.
Yeah, I know that shit. That shit, I was like, hilarious. And it was a hatchback, whatever you want to call them. Nah, W.
That's actually hilarious. I'm not going to lie.
Go ahead, grab it. Don't get scared.
Oh, this? Oh, yeah, I forgot about these. I'm not
sure. You can't forget, man. I'm scared. What does that shit say, bro?
Mr. Beast Valley. I mean, low key, I don't even really keep up with Mr. Beast like that, though.
Bro, one of the people that he's worked with got outed for being a pedo.
Oh, I did hear about that.
I don't know.
What was
like,
his name? I forgot.
Chris Tyson? Wait. Or Ava Tyson?
They go by Ava now.
Oh, was that the one that, okay, it's got the, you.
Yeah.
Yeah. The boy. That's crazy. Yeah. Bro, what?
Yeah, so I don't know. I don't know if Mr. Beast fired bro or not bro. She. Yeah. I don't know if Mr. Beast fired her, but
I have no idea. Yeah, I feel like
I don't even know if he's like
he came
even.
Out with the statement that he did.
Oh, he fired her.
Yeah, no, I saw a tweet. I think it was a tweet.
That he permanently removed her.
Mm. From. Damn. Do you know who Dr. Disrespect is?
Yeah.
Apparently,
him too.
he got caught up too. Mm-hmm. And there's this guy. What you finna say, go?
EDP. Is that what we're talking about?
No, go.
No. Okay. There was these glasses. I just saw a video. This is just video. There's these like reflecting glasses that was orange. Dr. Suspect had them, EDP had them, and I just saw a video of this man Charlie putting them on. I don't know if you know who Charlie is. Penguin, I think Moist Critical.
Oh yeah, Moist Critical.
This man just put them on, and this is a video of like how it was like started like the what's his name, Chris Moore. I forgot the show though, like, where people catch pedos and stuff like that.
Oh, Chris Hansen.
Yeah, Chris Hansen. Yeah. And it's like it was a flash of Dr. Disrespect and EDP. Like when you put the glasses on, that shit was crazy. I was like, there's no. Like, I mean, you wouldn't expect it though.
Yeah,
because like I didn't expect Dr. Disrespect to do something like that either.
Nah. So I know there's like pictures of him like with a kid, and everyone's like, "Oh, you should have known."
Wild.
It's crazy, bro. Like, you should have known. Like,
but no, Moist Critical, there's no way.
Yeah, he's oh yeah, no, I don't think Moist Critical. No, he's just too like.
Yeah, he's.
But then again, it'd be those guys.
I don't know, man. I don't think.
I'm not saying he is, but Moist Critical, I think he's very like he's a very like down to earth dude, and he's just very like I don't think he would do that.
I do like.
I feel like he's smarter than that.
Oh yeah, for sure.
You're dumb if you're doing some shit like that. Like. But
that's disgusting, I'm not gonna lie.
What's it called? There's this guy, Snake-O. I don't know if you know who he is.
Snake-O.
But he was like going crazy because like apparently like Dr. Disrespect was like getting shitted on and all this stuff because he was a pedo and he's like caught up. And then people, I guess, were like holding back on like hating on like Ava Tyson for being a pedo and shit because she's transgender.
I guess, man. I don't know. I wasn't me, even like, up with that.
I know. I don't know. To me, it's just like, bro, either you're a pedo or you're not.
Yeah,
like,
facts. There's no justifying that at all.
There's no justifying. I don't care if you're a tranny. I don't care if you're a white boy. It don't matter, bro.
Exactly.
Pedo is the label.
No way, bro.
But yeah, I don't really watch Mr. Beast like that. But
I don't either. Nah.
Mr. Beast, you're cool, I guess. I never really.
I mean, I
don't have anything against him, so.
I probably watch at least like 6 videos in my lifetime.
I think I watched one for the first time the other day, and it was like all the YouTubers for the $1 million.
I don't even know.
Exactly, bro.
I've been watching what's his name, Queso a lot.
Queso is so funny, bro.
I don't know. You know, you guys know Jev Fitzjev.
I might have to. I have to see his face. I have to see his face, bro. I'm more of a face guy. I can't really remember names like that.
No, Face Jeff, Queso. That's why I've been really.
He's in Face?
Yeah.
Oh, I definitely
he's still
know
Face. He's still Face. Surprisingly enough. Probably one of the better looking, ones, to be honest.
Face is looking goofy.
Yeah.
It's goofy, but it's kind of funny. I can't lie.
See, I don't keep up with anybody else. Like, I don't know if Rug is still in Face. Face Rug.
I think, yeah, he is.
But Jeff is the only person I keep up with.
Yeah, because they, like, kicked a lot of people out and then replaced them with, like, these goofy boys.
Yeah.
I can't lie. So, you know, like, Stable, like Ronaldo? Oh, you don't even know him?
I don't even know
any of the new FaZe members?
Nah, I'll just keep up with Jeff.
It might be a good thing, honestly, bro.
No, I don't even want to know,
bro. They're not even, like, gamers. Like, they're,
like...
like,
vlogging or stuff like that?
Kind of like just IRL streaming.
Nah.
Out there on the streets, like, clip farming.
What?
That's what they do now, clip farm.
Oh, heck nah, bro. That's actually horrible. Yeah. Nah, Jeff is still gaming. He's legit every day. He sometimes even posts twice a day just playing games. Like, he's mostly Elden Ring and stuff like that. Damn. And it's like extra other stuff. Like,
I need to lock in, bro. I haven't played the new shit.
Which ones?
The DLC that just dropped. Oh, no.
Me and my friend, his name is Doss. We're actually doing the seamless co-op mod where we can play the the actual Elden Ring, like, multiplayer.
Yeah.
And we're just, like, playing through it. And we're almost to the DLC, so we're going to buy DLC soon. And that's gonna be actually pretty fun.
Oh, bro. Yeah, they said that shit's hard.
No, yeah. Harder. I seen Jeff play it, bro. That shit is actually crazy. I'm not gonna lie. No,
bro,
I don't think I can do it.
That's why I'm waiting. I'm waiting a little bit. I was like, maybe I need to go play the other one again.
Anything from the base game doesn't matter.
I know.
It straight up just doesn't matter, bro. I don't know if
it's
I can do that.
It's all new stuff, bro.
Man.
I know. I saw one of my boys was playing it, and it was just funny watching him, because he's really? Just like running circles, basically trying to figure some shit out. I'm like, it's like that already?
That's crazy.
He's like, yeah, dude, this shit's so fucking hard, and you can tell in his voice that he's like pissed. He's like fucking pissed.
No way.
Yeah, he's like, bro, you get this game if you really want to fucking rage.
I mean, I feel like it's gonna be easy. I mean, hey, if you want to play Elden Ring, we can get the mod. If we can
shit,
run it.
I might have to, bro. I haven't.
It's actually fun.
I played back in the day. Like, I haven't played on the PC. I played back in the day, like, on the Xbox and stuff. So, I don't really. It's probably the same, but.
No, you're going to have to use a controller still. Really? I don't use mouse, keyboard, and other. There's no way.
Oh, it's
I tried.
Hard?
It's hard? It's so confusing.
Yeah, I might have to slide on
the amount of times controller. I've, like, sold myself because I actually clicked the wrong button at the wrong time.
Yeah, you're right. You're right.
I couldn't do it. The controller is better.
I think I just like story games better on controller.
Oh, no, yeah. 100%. Yeah, like Red Dead and stuff like that?
Red Dead. Oh, bro, Red Dead.
That's nice.
Peak. Mm-hmm. Oh, Red Dead. For me, like, one of my favorite ones is God of War Ragnarok, bro.
Damn, I never played that.
You need to, bro.
I never
what
played
is
it.
Wrong with you, bro?
I haven't played any of the God of War games except the one on the PS2.
Oh, that one's good.
Don't know what it is, though. It's got like one of the classics. Part. Dad walked in. It was the old God of War days. You're smashing buttons and you're doing other things. Not good for someone who's what, 10 maybe.
Yeah,
he walked in and said, "What's going on?" Banned completely from the game. Not gonna lie.
That's crazy.
Not gonna lie.
That's crazy.
I don't even think I made it past the the actual epilogue of the game.
Damn.
It was so much. That's it was crazy. Just too much stuff.
I know, because I think now on the PlayStation 5, it'll let you like play all the PS2 games and all that.
Oh, what
stuff.
I did not know that. I know. Actually.
So like you can play like all the old COD games that are still up and shit. Like, I think they just shut out. They shut down Battlefield servers, I think.
Oh, that's true. I mean, I wasn't really a Battlefield.
I mean, neither, but
I was more of a Call of Duty and stuff.
Yeah, same.
Do you have a PS5?
Yeah.
I feel like you do have a PS5.
It's like laying on the floor over there.
Of course.
It's like on the other side of that manga there.
I don't even see it, but I don't know. I'm more strictly PC now.
I probably got on PC like 2-3 years ago. Mm-hmm. And then I was like, this is the shit. Like, I don't know why I didn't have PC before.
Yeah, no, facts.
It's just better.
It's just a lot better,
like,
in my opinion.
I don't know. I don't give a fuck what anybody says, but PC is better than console.
Yeah.
Any day of the week.
Like, always. Mm. There's no denying it.
There's no denying it. Like,
you can
I don't
do so much more with
it. Yeah, so much more. They're expensive at the beginning, but it is like saving your money over
time.
Yeah,
facts. I feel like because you have to keep on buying games on like console and stuff like that.
Yeah, it's games just gonna keep and adding like up. 4 years, you got to buy a new console because that shit.
Oh yeah, that's true. You got to keep on upgrading.
Bro, you're trying to get that cat. She's like doing two extra stuff on my plants, dude. But like, I don't know, like. Mm-hmm. PC, like, you need to upgrade something, you just pull a part out of it at one end. Like, easy as that. You can have that PC forever to the end of your days.
For a console, you had to buy an entire new thing. You're never guaranteed to get it.
Fuck that. Yeah, like, I got my Xbox, like, one right here behind this stuff.
Oh, yeah. Sign
here. I don't really use it. I want to keep on my console so that when I, like, get older, I'm like, oh, yeah, look at all these consoles.
Bro, yeah, make a little collection.
Yes, oh, like, shelf collection. I'll show you
that. That's pretty cool. I'm not going to lie. That's pretty cool.
What's your favorite game on PC, though?
Ooh.
Bro, I was gonna say Apex.
Oh, hell no. I hate Apex with a burning passion, bro. But it's the game I have the most hours in. And I'm still
dog shit
at it.
It's crazy.
I'm still dog shit. But I think I have like 1,400 hours in Apex.
Jesus Christ.
And I'm still dog shit. Not even having hit masters.
Bro's trying to get good.
I was on the KSU's esports team.
Damn.
But it was just I hate it.
What did they play?
What do you mean?
Like, what games did y'all play for the esports team?
Oh, we had Rocket League, we had League of Legends, Apex, Rainbow Six. I think I feel like I'm missing one.
It's a W team right there, bro.
I feel forget. I feel like I'm missing one though, but it was actually nice. We went to, there was an event in Atlanta that we had, like, it's like a stage. We legit got on the stage and played in front of people. Stage? Yeah, it was crazy. Sheesh. It was crazy.
No, that's lit. Mm-hmm. That's actually lit.
But I don't know what my favorite game is, to be honest.
Like, what is a game that you could always play, like, always come back to and, like, not ever get bored of it?
This might sound weird, I'm not gonna lie. I don't know if y'all know what Ace Combat is.
No.
Nope. It's a dog fighting game. I don't know. I grew up on it. I have no idea why. I grew up on the game. I have no idea. But I can name, like, my top five. That'll be pretty easy.
Go for top five.
Top five. It has to be Ace Combat. I don't know why. Okay. It is Monster Hunter.
Okay.
A diehard fan of Monster Hunter. Played it since the 3DS. Mortal Kombat. Any Mortal Kombat game. Actually goaded at them. What's that? Number three. We got... I played Red Dead Redemption for a while, especially with my friends online.
Yeah.
Amazing game. Recommend it 100%. 10 out of 10. Last game, I would probably say... Oh, Minecraft. Gotta put a spot for Minecraft, bro. I'm not gonna lie. I love Minecraft
low-key, like, yes, has friends, been around forever, bro. Dude,
I don't care. It can never get boring from here.
No, it really doesn't,
especially
bro.
When you get that phase. Bro.
It's over.
Sitting there for months.
Yeah, for no reason. Just building and not getting active in survival. Literally, like, yeah, Minecraft literally. Has been around for too long.
I don't know what it is. A little childish, but I don't care.
Yeah, no, that shit's still good. I still see people, like, streaming that shit, mm-hmm. making YouTube videos for that shit. Like, that shit's, like...
Yes, man.
Sometimes I like to, like, look... Because I used to watch this guy, Stampy Longhead.
So, oh, that sounds familiar.
He used to, like, rock a CAT scan on, and he did, like, a survival world. He'd had, like, 300 days of my survival world.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
There's another guy, about, Lion Maker. Oh, God, I think he got caught
is.
Up.
But I know who the other person was. I know who it is.
Stampy Longhead.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, you know? Mm-hmm.
I always like to see, like, and then there's this other guy, Diamond DXD, guy with blue hair. I forget. It's like a white guy. Nah. I forget. Mm-mm. But I'm like, what are they doing now?
Oh, funny. Bro, yeah.
Shout out PewDiePie, though, man. He's living life, bro.
No, yeah, facts.
Bro had a baby. Bro, in his dad era.
He's actually chilling.
Yeah, he is living, God. Bro. Bro is him, Loki. I love PewDiePie. He's so funny. Bro's different. Deal breaker?
As in what? In what context?
I have no idea. I didn't write this.
You didn't write it?
No, she does.
Oh. Oh, what context
like,
then?
Just, like, what's a deal breaker? Like,
what does deal breaker mean? Like,
I don't know. Usually it's, like, in context of, like, a relationship. But, like, it could be anything.
Fuck, I don't know, bro.
I don't know. Man, I got that's the thing I gotta think on.
Yeah, I don't know.
Because I won't know until I see it.
Tight shit, not washing your ass. That's a deal
crazy.
Breaker.
That is definitely
that's a deal breaker.
You have me stinking, bro.
If your ass stink, bro.
Yo,
that's a deal breaker. No, way. No lie.
Yeah. Rude, bitchy, you know what I mean?
Rude and bitchy.
Yeah. I have my fair share of that. Not gonna lie.
That's wild.
Yeah.
It'd be like that. That's real. That's real right facts. There.
You don't want that for, I don't know, I'll be how long
I'm just trying to vibe, dude.
Yeah, facts.
Like, I'm just trying to chill for real. No, that's valid.
Your point is valid. Your point is real valid.
Yeah, deal breaker, Beyonce or Taylor Swift?
Oh, Beyonce, in my opinion. That's just me.
You don't fuck with Taylor?
I don't think I've listened to, like, one of her songs. I cannot memorize a single song from Taylor Swift.
I don't memorize them, but I can probably name like one.
I can't even name the a song.
Hold on, let me think. I don't know. I was about to name on. I literally can't.
No offense. I don't know.
Let me name a Beyonce song real quick. I can't name one.
No.
That's crazy.
Hold on, chill. I was just listening to one earlier, bro. I don't know. Single Ladies, right? That's one.
There you go. Yeah.
That's shit.
Irreplaceable.
I know. I was listening to Irreplaceable earlier.
Yeah.
But, yeah. I got a couple of her songs in my playlist.
Oh, yeah. For sure, yeah.
She's valid.
What kind of music have you listened to?
Me?
Because I remember, like, I was in one of your streams, and you're like, we're listening to music, and someone sent you a playlist that you were playing. You said this playlist is fire. Now, always like, what kind of music you listen to?
Dude, I listen to everything, bro. I go from, like, Beethoven to Juice WRLD to Panic at the Disco. So I literally listen to everything. Anything that hits my ears and it sounds good, like, I'll listen. Like, I listen to a lot of K-pop. Valid. Like, literally, like, especially, like, anime intros. Like, if I hear an anime intro that I like, I'm going to Apple Music and I'm looking it up.
Really?
We downloading it
there.
Yeah. Like, that's how I am. So I really listen to, like, everything. Like, I don't really, like, try to... I used to, like, what's it called? Like, only keep myself to certain music, but now, like, I
can't even find myself just in one genre. I can't do that.
Oh, yeah.
I'm everywhere. I think the only genres I'm not really into a lot is either heavy metal or... country. That's it.
I can't even lie. I got some heavy metal and some country.
Oh, no. I got some, too, but not as heavy as, like, everything else.
Oh, yeah. Facts. Yeah. We ain't listening to no country on the daily like that. It's just one song, you know? Yeah,
pretty much. There's, like, a couple, like, one or two.
Yeah. On my big green tractor. Songs.
That's crazy.
That's that Jason Aldean right there.
No way. Always the same thing.
No, yeah. I'm trying to think of some other songs that what did I listen to today? I think I was listening to, like, random shit today.
I think I'm in my breakcore phase right now. I'm not gonna lie.
Damn. I like older songs too a lot.
Really? Like 2000 or
like
what?
Older, like oh, older, damn, older. Like, what am I trying to think of? Like Red Hot Chili Peppers, like, you know who that is? Californication, bro, you don't know that song?
Damn.
Like, I don't even remember any old songs. Yeah, probably like 2002 back.
Oh, no, I'm not that far back.
No, you need to log in.
I'm not far back. Hey, you can put me on it.
Oh, I'm going to put you on, bro. Yeah, you can. My playlist is literally called Shut the Fuck Up.
Are you serious?
Just listen. Literally, bro. No way. It's like an anime girl with a gun, like, no, I swear. Bro,
that's crazy.
Yeah, bro.
It's on Spotify or what?
I literally had to do it on Spotify. I had, like, because I rock with Apple Music, but when I got on Spotify, because I use Spotify on my computer.
Okay, gotcha.
It's just better. Like, Spotify is just, like...
Yes, I don't know why people prefer everything else with Spotify. I think Spotify is better. I'm just saying.
Like, their playlists are better, their songs are better. Literally. They have more songs on Spotify than they do on Apple Music.
No, yeah. Really?
Yes.
I wouldn't know.
Because, like, some songs I'll look up on Spotify, I'll find them directly. I go on Apple Music and nothing. I can't find them.
I think SoundCloud is the place where you find, like, remixes. Like social media and stuff like that, where people just post like random shit,
unreleased type shit. Yeah, that's why I go to SoundCloud for that unreleased type shit.
Other than that, what was I gonna? I forgot. Your top games. I forgot to ask that when we were in that subject earlier.
My top five games. Mm-hmm. Shit. Low key, number one, can't even lie, it's gotta be Valorant. I haven't even been playing for that long.
Okay.
Like, I've been playing for, like, maybe, like, three years probably on Valorant. Like, but something about Valorant has, like, pulled me in and, like,
you know what's weird? I mean, I grew up on CSGO, like, in, like, middle school? We legit had CSGO in middle school on the, like, actual computers. Yeah. Like, someone would bring a flash, I'd plug it in and download on the computer, and we just play in the back of the room. Bro, I was so shit at it. But, like, when I got better over the years of, like, just regular FPS, I went back to it, like, this, like CSGO 2.
Yeah.
I was freaking dogging people. Like, I was dragging people. I didn't think... I mean, no, I went to Valorant. Same thing.
Oh, yeah.
But I hate the game.
It's your aim. Your aim
is goated. No, literally, that's all it is.
Your aim is goated.
No, not in Valorant. Just Bloom. That's Chance. That both goes sideways when you shoot off the gun.
Talk about, bro. Valorant is, like, all about aim, bro. No, it's yes, I not. Swear
it's
it
all
is.
About Chance and the dice
no,
roll.
No, bro. Fuck Chance and the dice roll. I don't know who the fuck told you that.
Nah, bro. My experience of playing Valorant.
You didn't play long enough, bro.
Man, there's no way, bro.
You just gotta know what's happening.
Yeah, okay.
Like, when you don't know what's happening, that's why it's, like, Chance and dice roll. Because then you just get blinded out of nowhere and you're like, what the fuck is going on?
I guess, yeah. But, like, when I'm aiming there, if I'm sitting there in a corner with the actual reticle just sitting there.
Bro, is ADSing?
No.
Oh.
No. Like, with the actual crosshair. And someone walks across the screen, I shoot, I see the bullet go. I have a clip of it in my PC right now of the bullet going that way when I shot the gun.
That's crazy.
When he was this way. So that was the day I actually uninstalled the
game. You gotta, like.
No, look, like, F8. Bow. Clip it. And there was
You gotta go light on that mouse. You gotta, like.
Does it actually matter how hard you press it? That's ridiculous.
If you hold it, that's crazy. It starts spraying. You gotta, like, one tap. One bullet, one bullet. I know how to learn that shit too.
I had no idea.
Cause, like, yeah, the, like, one thing is you can't move and run on Valorant because you're just gonna spray everywhere. Mm. And another thing is, like, you have to hold your recoil and, like.
That's crazy.
Yeah, cause if you, like, hold it, it'll start going up.
Cause I press my mouse, like, I'm about to break.
You had to, like, tap that. You gotta literally let out one bullet.
Oh my god! Nah, if you heard my streams, like my older streams, where I had, like, no, like, mic suppression or anything, it was just like pow, 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 pow. Just the mouse just click,
click,
just clicking.
So that used to be me on my fucking keyboard. Oh my I had this god. Little dingy keyboard, and it's just so fucking loud.
No, like, literally, that's how it was. Oh my, okay, that makes a lot of sense.
Valorant, let me think. Two. I don't know what two would be, bro. I'm gonna put Call of Duty. Any Call of Duty.
Okay. I haven't played Call of Duty since 2019.
Yeah, I think the last Call... It's been a year now since I played Call of Duty. Mm-hmm. I literally bought the new one and didn't even touch it. Mm. Like, Call of Duty, because that's a game that, I don't know, I can just get in there and just start killing 30 bodies and literally. Get off.
Mm.
Minecraft is third. What else, bro? I'm gonna put God of War up there, because that's, like...
Okay, that's valid. That's valid.
I like the story.
I've only seen, like, playthroughs of it. I actually never played it myself. Yeah. I just saw, like, other people.
Even watching it is still, like, literally. Really, really cool. Fifth? Shit.
No, fifth is kind of hard.
Genshin Impact. I used to be a very, very, I used to be that motherfucking, what do you call them? What do they call them?
You know.
Femboy.
Wow.
I used to be deep in Genshin.
See, I tried Genshin Impact. I played it with my friend, but like, we deleted it the day of we played it. I mean, there's nothing wrong with the game. There's nothing wrong with the game. I feel like it was it could have been a really fun game, but when I was playing it, we tried to play multiplayer. And we had to do something, like, a lot just to unlock multiplayer so we can play with our friends. We didn't get it. We're sitting for, like, at least 5-6 hours trying to get multiplayer. Yeah, trying to level up.
Yeah, I think you have to hit, like, a certain level to unlock
it. And we just quit. And we deleted the game. So I didn't even give it a chance, to be honest. I just went through the tutorial and that was it.
Yeah, I think, it's just got a special place in my heart because when I started streaming, that was the first game I played when I started streaming.
Oh,
and like it just like okay. Like a lot of people were fucking with it.
Yeah.
I don't know what it is. Like a lot of femboys were following me.
That's crazy.
I swear.
That's crazy.
Like, yeah, they were like, oh shit. I was like, I didn't even know Genshin was that popular. Wow. But it really is popular.
It won awards, didn't it?
Yeah.
The game of the year. It wasn't Game of the Year, was it?
I don't think.
What was game? Was Elden Ring Game of the Year last year?
I don't know, but we're about to find out because. Mm-hmm. I can't let that one just not be answered.
I was not expecting Genshin Impact to be number 5.
What you mean, bro?
I thought it would be like Mortal Kombat or something.
I like Mortal Kombat. Oh, no, it was Baldur's Gate. Fuck that game.
No, actually, no. Baldur's
Gate
is
trash.
No!
I tried to play it and I was like, what the fuck is this?
You know what? Okay, valid.
I was like,
the beginning was kind of wonky. I'm not going to lie. It was kind of weird. But once you get past, like, when you get to like the actual world itself, it's actually amazing.
Yeah, I like open world games like that. Though. That's why I like Genshin.
The amount of like freedom you have in the game is insane, and I forgot what the amount of hours they put into the game is insane.
Damn,
I've been trying to get it again for Inaru, but bro, they're just I'm just waiting for a sale. Nothing on sale.
No, they know, bro. they know better, bro.
Yeah, bro. They got the self worth because they ain't gonna put that thing down.
They won game of the year for a reason.
Yeah,
brother.
So I'm just like, all right, I'm just gonna have to bite the bullet and just buy it full price. But
nah, facts. Did you ever get into Cyberpunk?
No, I just watched the anime.
Oh, the anime?
Bro, that
shit was crazy, bro.
I have the freaking, what's it called, the soundtrack in my own repeat all times.
This song is fire, and then the other one is
Stay at Your House.
Stay at Your House, song.
Man.
That shit's in my vibes.
It's actually
that song is crazy.
Like when I watch it, the amount of times I put people onto it is insane. I was actually praising
a little 13 up.
Oh, yeah.
Or 20, I don't know, I think it was 13.
Mm-hmm.
But,
bro,
13 up's hit different.
Easy. It was easy.
I know. I think they like dropped the game, and I think they dropped like another game. I wish they would make it like multiplayer.
What's the DLC of the?
I think it's something.
Game?
Yeah, it's like Cyberpunk.
I just never played the actual game itself.
It's just a story mode game. It's open world, and it's kind of like GTA basically, but like just story, no multiplayer.
Yeah, because like more futuristic, right?
Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
But if they had a multiplayer, bro, like open world, like GTA was, they'd probably do so much.
Dog, that would be crazy.
That would be so good.
I don't know how they do it though. I wonder how chaotic that would be.
It'd be crazy.
Because I've seen like gameplay of like what you can do in the game. That's crazy. I don't know how this what's McCall would be online.
It would be better though. Like open world like that, like because it'd be kind of like the show.
No, literally, actually.
Like,
we're going to be our own person or something.
Exactly.
Like that, bro.
Like, and then you go meet up your homies and go do a mission.
That's
like,
crazy.
Exactly. Like, brother, like, y'all need to get on this Cyberpunk. What the hell are y'all doing?
Yeah.
People are dogging
losing
on that game.
Losing money.
Yeah, not fact.
Bro. If like, modders can do it.
Because I think, literally, the show was what got me on the game. I was like, the show?
Mm-hmm.
Peak. I think one of my buddies had the game, and he was like, yeah, I got so many fucking hours in this game.
That's
he's
crazy.
Literally a guy that plays Rust, so I already know he's goofy.
Yep.
He's goofy. Them Rust players, man.
No, they're y'all are built, dude. Riding in the chairs. I'm not going to lie.
I joined in first. I think I played once. It wasn't even on my computer. It was on my friend's computer. As soon as I got in, I smell a monkey. I was like,
that's
what?
Crazy.
What is happening? I haven't even spoken.
That's wild.
I haven't even talked yet.
He already knew.
I was like, it's knew. Like that. I was like, yeah, I'll play in my own time if I want to,
bro. My friend sent me so many clips of things like that, bro. It's hilarious.
No, they don't play in Rust, bro. They do not play.
Oh, there's this game called Insurgency Sandstorm. It's like a hyper-realistic game. The amount of insults, because it's like older guys playing the game.
Yeah.
The amount of insults I've been like talked over my way is insane. Like, things I didn't even know was racist. Because I had to go back and like, what do you call me? Type it up. Oh my
shit.
God.
This motherfucker knows
this is something.
History.
Yeah, fact. I don't know where he came from or where he is from, but that's ridiculous.
No,
I'm not gonna lie.
They be like coming up with some. I'm like, damn, y'all got time on y'all's hands,
bro.
Ain't no
that's
way.
Insane. The things they be creating.
Them grown up COD players, bro.
Nah,
that's what
yep,
it be.
That's where they go. Yeah, that's where they go. Bro. They're tired of getting dragged by kids.
I know. It's just, yeah.
Damn.
People that's out here insane. Like think it's like be out talking soft and shit, but y'all hop in a COD lobby or some shit. Go hop in a Rust lobby, bro.
Oh yeah,
they gonna tear you apart, dude. They gonna get active on your ass. Mm-hmm. Cats or dogs?
Ooh, dogs.
Why?
I'm just now warming up the cats, like
literally just
in the year or so. Oh,
I thought you were talking about like just because you walked in here and there's cats.
My friend had a cat. His name is Roxy, and that was the first cat. Me and though she attacked me.
She scarred you, bro.
Yeah.
Damn.
My back. I think there's still a scar back here.
She too. Like attacked
me? Well, it wasn't like attack. My friend threw her on me.
Oh, damn.
Then she like legit freaked out and like attacked my back. But other than that, that was that one incident and then a bunch of other ones that made me not like cats. But she was the one that like actually started making me warm up to cats.
Mm.
Then my friend Dawes, well, my best friend Dawes, he has a bunch of cats at his house. I mean,
yeah.
And obviously I'm over there a lot and just started warming up. So it's like this year, I just started like liking cats.
Salad. Mm-hmm. Shit, you better, bro. I like dogs, but cats to me are a little bit easier.
Yeah, no,
like
for maintenance sure, wise. For sure.
Yeah, like I don't 100%. Have to take them out. I have automatic litters, I have automatic feeders. Mm-hmm. Empty them out, fill them up.
It's
you know,
a lot it's, easier, yeah.
And they're just vibing. They're not really. They don't really do. Know. They fight and shit, but
yeah,
they don't.
Cavy in them, bro. While I was here when the cavy ran up the stairs and tried to
box them up.
I forgot who it was.
She was trying to box up one of the cats.
Mm-hmm. I think did she like run in here?
Oh, yeah, I had to get active. I think I was on the game or something.
I know.
What the fuck? The fuck is going on?
Y'all legit heard y'all scream. I thought, there's no way.
I know, bro. Don't interrupt me in the middle of a game, bro. That's I'm gonna be crazy. Mad, bro.
That's crazy.
I'm over here trying to drop some bodies, trying not to get dropped, and a fucking dog's up here barking up and shit.
I can see myself actually getting a cat, though. I can.
Oh yeah.
I can.
Yeah, they're nice.
I probably have to get a dog and a cat at the same time, though, just so they can grow up together, so it's no problems.
Yeah. Get them at like babies and shit. Mm. Usually, it's the cat that has more of the problems of. The dog usually are chilling because they just know like I can fuck you up any second of the day.
Yeah, they're literally, absolutely.
But sometimes the cats be like kind of dominating.
Yeah, I need like exotic pets. I saw there's like a case over there, right?
Where?
Man's
oh yeah, man. I got leopard geckos.
Oh, how many? You say geckos?
Two.
Plural. Oh.
One in each cage. Yeah, they're the most exotic.
I didn't even see that other cage.
I had a snake, but oh, you didn't see that.
I didn't even realize I was there, to be honest.
No, I think I had a snake, but rip, bro.
Aww.
Rip Natsu, man.
Dang.
Yeah.
You used to have bunnies too.
Yeah, you used to have bunnies too.
Oh wow, you guys have everything.
Yeah, in the apartment.
You used to have a zoo.
Yeah, in the apartment I had a zoo. No lie, I had like hella shit.
Dang.
I was going crazy. It's because like when I was a kid, like. Nah, you can get no pets.
No, literally, back in my house, I was not able to.
I had to get active as soon as I got out the crib, get some pets. I was literally here before I moved out, I was literally hiding a gecko.
Are you serious?
I was like, literally hiding them in my room. And I was like, oh shit, if I get caught with this motherfucker.
No shot, bro. That's crazy.
So yeah, like, I was like, fuck it, I don't need to move out if I'm trying to keep my gecko. So
that's
yeah.
Amazing.
Yeah, and then fish. I had like two cichlids. They grew pretty big, probably like.
I don't know too much about fish, to be honest. I know my dad had like a huge tank back in the day when we were growing up. I just never knew. Like, I never got into them too much.
Yeah. I think cichlids, I just got them from fucking PetSmart and they died of parasites.
That's crazy.
I know. So I'm never going to buy a fish from PetSmart again.
No, that's wild.
Yeah. They like literally, I looked it up and it was like, yeah, parasite goes in their head and then they start seizing.
That's wild.
And hitting the tank. I had a 50 gallon tank. I would be sleeping at night and I would hear the fish seizing because he got like about this big.
Jeez,
and he would just seize hitting the walls of the tank, just going boom, 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 boom. I'm like, nah, bro. I felt bad. And you would see him, and he had like a hole in his head. I named him fucking Emma and Ray from Promise Neverland.
Sue him. Sue Pesper. That's all you gotta do.
I can only do so much. Yeah, shit. Fuck. Yeah, because I think one of my bunnies I got from PetSmart died.
He said, nah, see, now.
Everything from PetSmart that I got, even that motherfucking snake died.
I don't even do it. That's crazy. Might as well go to Facebook Marketplace to get something. That's crazy.
Facebook Marketplace for a pet is crazy.
Yo.
Yo, I might have to look that up, see if they're
going to actually, I might need to, actually, because I just do that out of the blue, because I don't even know. That'd be kind of crazy. I'm not going to lie.
Yeah, don't shop from PetSmart if you're trying to get pets.
Yeah.
Only if you're trying to get. The only ones that haven't died is this bitch. Here that fat bitch right there
really
yeah she was like
no.
They were using
yeah it's like a middleman.
Okay, got you. Yeah,
and then the other one I got from the streets.
Oh, okay. Which one's which one's Nova?
Nova's the one on the window over there. Luna's the one laying there. Yeah, no, I picked Nova up off the street. She had like worms in her stomach.
Really?
She had fleas, all this bullshit. She's good now, you know, nothing too crazy, nothing too lit. How do you feel about Biden dropping out?
See, politics.
Yeah, you really deep in politics like that?
No.
I have opinions, but I don't really give a fuck. Like, shit, I'm not going to vote. Man. I don't vote.
I don't vote. I haven't voted.
Because you older?
I haven't voted at all.
How old are you?
21.
Oh yeah, you're the same age as me.
Yeah, I haven't voted.
Yeah, I know. Literally, I have not voted once. Like, because to me, there's no point.
Yeah.
To me, it's just rigged. Like.
I'm not even gonna be here. I want to go somewhere else. I'm
gonna exactly, bro. I don't even. The United States, man. You barely holding me together, man.
Not gonna lie. Shoot.
But Biden, yeah, you should have been dropped out, brother. You're a cool guy, but I saw you dap somebody up in a Waffle House, but. I saw him dap up somebody in Waffle House. He like walked in, he looks at the camera, and he's like, oh shit.
No way, bro. I was like, what the fuck? There's no shot. Yo, this man Biden, I don't know, man. He's just old.
I know.
The amount of clips I've seen of this man just like spacing out is insane.
I know. One time I saw him saluting a tree. I swear. There's a video of him saluting.
I know exactly what video you're talking about.
That shit's fucked up.
Oh hey. My god, bro!
Thank you for your service,
that's
tree.
Crazy,
thank you,
man.
For the air.
He knows he's been there as long as him. I'm just saying, bro.
Yeah, he is crazy. Old.
He is old, yo.
No, that shit is. Yeah, it's kind of sad. Like they're really just using his ass.
No, yeah,
that's all he is. I know. I saw like a tweet the other day, and it was like, it's crazy how we still don't know who's running the United States of America.
Yeah, pretty much. Man's reading cards. Not gonna lie, he's that mayor from Chicken Little, bro.
No, literally.
Mm-hmm.
And when the card isn't there, he's lost. He's fucking clueless. If that card don't say shit on it, he's just staring at it.
Man, that's tragic. I'm not gonna lie.
Shout out Biden though, bro. You did what you could, I guess.
You're, yeah, that's literally that's what all you can, that's all yeah. you can say.
Yeah,
you did what you could.
You did what you could,
or capable of doing.
Yeah, I don't even know how old he is, but shout out, bro. Shout out the elderly too, man.
He's like 80 or something.
Is he?
80 is crazy.
That is crazy.
You're like 20 years away from 100?
Yeah. That can go quick, too. I'm not gonna lie.
No, that should have been quick, low-key.
Mm-hmm. My biggest struggle in life.
81?
Of course, I pulled that one.
Your biggest struggle in life?
Your biggest struggle in life.
Fuck. Money.
Oh, yeah. Right, that's all I can money, say is bro. Money. Yeah, that's bro. It.
I don't even know how many times I've said this, but living is expensive, bro.
Yeah.
Living is hell. I feel like I'm fucking paying for air. I'm paying to breathe.
No, bro, actually, pretty
like,
much.
Every time I look at my bank, somebody took some money out of it.
Oh
like,
my
what the fuck
gosh,
are we doing?
That's the worst feeling
like,
ever.
What? I swear I just had $100 in here.
Oh my. I remember this one time. I was like, okay, let me go get some gas real quick. I started pumping the gas. It gave me 12 cents. And it cut off. I looked at my account. $75 was taken out of my account. I was like, where is this from? It was an old subscription I had so long ago.
I know.
A yearly subscription.
Literally one day I had to sit down. I was like, all right, let me see what fucking subscriptions I got. Because this is fucking getting out of hand here.
It's bad, bro.
No, it's bad.
Man, it was bad. I couldn't. Money, bro. That's all it is.
Yeah. Shit.
I'm a pretty happy dude. But money? Man.
Should be fucking tearing me up.
I wouldn't do nothing strange for some change, but like
shit, I won. Shit, I would. We get to that point in life, man. Next thing you know, you're gonna see the Abyss OnlyFans.
Oh, that's wild. That's wild. Oh man, I don't know if I can scoop
Not
that
jokes,
low. To
jokes.
Be honest, I couldn't do it.
Mm-mm. No, I swear the girl we had on here before you. No hate. I have no shame. Before I even say this, no shame, no hate towards anybody that does OnlyFans. You know, you grinding, you fucking hustling, you do what you got to do to get your money.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, on God, the girl that we had here before you, like she had an OnlyFans. I didn't want to bring it up, but I swear she said it. I'm just like, oh, she kind of like, okay. It's like, oh, like it kind of catches me off guard. Like, oh, you got an OnlyFans. And I'm friends with her brother.
Oh.
Because that's how I really know her through her. I don't really know her, but she wanted to be on the podcast because her brother was on. And he was like, don't tell me all that. Don't tell
that's
me.
That's crazy, like, no, bro.
Yeah, she made a joke. She's like, I might have to sell my pussy for rent.
That's crazy. Oh, my God. Yeah, nah, I couldn't, bro. Could not. Made some good cards. Props. Ooh, favorite artist. See, I can't even answer that.
What is it?
Favorite artist.
Oh, shit.
I have too many. I listen to too much music. Like.
Favorite artist.
You know what? Kamiyada Plus.
That's crazy.
Don't know if y'all know who that is.
Yeah, I have one song.
Kamiyada Plus
crazy.
Is my favorite. As of right now.
Shit, me?
We'll change it. What's the first artist that you remember, like, ever listening to? Like, what's like a first, like, song or something?
First song
Animals by Neon. Bro, I had that song on repeat when I was a kid.
Mine was probably fucking some Nickelback. I'm not even gonna lie to you. For some reason, like, Nickelback just, like, takes me back. Yo,
no.
Look at this phone. All I think about is a meme now. They fucked that guy up with just putting the meme up.
Dang, look at this graph. That's crazy. I know exactly what you're talking about.
Yeah, I know.
It had to be Animals Neon, though. I don't know what the next, I think Neon City was it?
Yeah.
Neon City? That's what it was. I was in daycare playing with Legos. Little EJ playing with Legos. This dude came up with an iPod. Gave me iPod listening to music. That's how I was singing my heart out in the middle of the freaking daycare, bro. Just playing with Legos.
No, shout out to iPod. Bro, I haven't seen an iPod in so long.
Oh, no.
Do they even make them anymore?
Oh, there's no way.
Yeah,
there's
no way. Mm-mm. Them shits were, I think I have one somewhere, just, but I don't have a charger for it.
I found one, like the little tiny one. I think it was like the iPod Shuffle, mini. Bro. Was it the Shuffles?
Oh, yeah.
I just found one just randomly.
Put that in. Press play.
Yeah, that used to be the shit back in the day.
Just download all the music on there, bro. Yeah, man.
I know how times have changed.
Oh, yeah.
We got the phone now that can do every goddamn literally thing you needed everything to do. Like, shit can hold your music, hold your photos, hold your fucking...
Everything.
Everything, literally.
There's no worries about it.
Nah.
Biggest pet peeve. Oh, boy, oh, boy. My biggest pet peeve I'm realizing just now recently is when people cough just wide out and open.
What you mean?
Like straight up. Nah. Just like, no elbows, no hands.
Oh, just like,
bah. Just, yep.
That's crazy. Yep. Who was coughing like that? Oh, my
God. Bro, I was walking, I think it was like a couple days ago when I was over here. We were walking at Sam's Club. There was this lady just walking right past us, started coughing, tongue curled up in a circle, just shooting it. Just shooting this cough. Bro, I was like, there's no way you out here, like, walking like
this. There's no way.
Just coughing on people. I work in a pharmacy, and, like, the amount of people that be there, COVID, no masks, just coughing in the air. I'm just sitting on the computer because I'd be talking to people, like ringing them out and everything like that. And I just look at someone. He walks up to the thing. This was today. He started coughing. Just no mask, anything. He picked up the COVID medication. I was like, bro, he's like legit coughing.
That's
at
crazy.
Us.
Crazy. Picking like, up COVID medication and coughing
nothing,
is crazy.
No mask, nothing. Just coming up in there, just
bro's,
spreading it.
Yeah, I was about to say, bro's definitely trying to spread it.
We cleaned that entire, we took 30 minutes and cleaned the entire place. We got sprayed down with lights on everything.
Damn. That is wild. Yeah, you got to, though. Literally.
We're in, like, we're exposed to everything in there.
Yeah. People don't give a fuck.
No, they don't.
That's what it is. Like, people do not give two fucks, bro. Shit, my biggest pet peeve is probably people with fat heads. Like, motherfuckers who think they know everything.
Okay. I thought you meant, like, actual, like...
Oh, yeah, shit. You can put that one in there and correlate it together.
Crazy.
But, yeah, people with fat-ass heads that they just think that the world is around them.
Like, big egos?
Yeah. Not only just big egos, but, like, they think they know everything, but then you see them and they, like, obviously don't know everything. Like, no, you don't know how to tie your shoe.
Calm down.
You don't know how to put on pants, right? Calm the fuck down. Like, let's be real here, man.
Yeah, I understand that 100%.
Or like how they tell you, like trying to tell you how to do something, but you already know how to do it. Shit like that.
Oh,
like,
my God. Yeah.
Like, facts. Bro, chill. You're new.
Brother.
You're new, brother. Calm down. No one knows you. Like,
bro, nah.
Yeah, I guess big heads.
That's valid. That's valid indeed. Yeah.
Yeah, nah, facts. Like, can't stand that shit. Mm-hmm. And I'm not really someone to like say it. Like, I just kind of, because for me, it's like I'm better to be quiet and let shit slide than talk or like try
yeah.
to.
Yeah. Because there's a bunch of times, especially at work, dealing with a lot of people at work.
Oh, yeah?
And they're, like bitchy, of course.
Yeah, of course.
Especially the older ones. Oh, my God.
They don't give a fuck.
And I'm nonchalant in work. Then, like, the way people be saying stuff, like, my coworkers get mad. I just let it off. Like, they'd be like, well, you gonna let her speak to you like that and everything? I'm like, nah. I mean, it's whatever.
Yeah.
To be honest. I mean, it doesn't really...
Exactly. Like,
I grew up in cod lobbies, bro. I get nothing, like you can't really insult me on that.
It does not matter.
Yeah.
Like, it really does not matter.
I can't.
Life is not that deep.
I'll just laugh at you. I laughed at someone's face before because they were mad at me.
Yeah, give them a little smile.
I did get in trouble, Bart, though. I legit started bust out laughing in someone's face.
My thing is, like, I just be staring.
No, yeah, I'll either stare at your face, like, dead at, like staring
just dead
the eyes.
Stare, like, mm-hmm. Are you being real? Are you being dead ass?
Or I'll just burst out laughing in your face, bro.
No,
I have to walk away.
This is crazy.
Because, bro, I can't take you seriously at all.
Yeah, I can't. Taking people serious these days is hard.
Unless you throw something, you know. bro, I think it was like a month ago. No, not a month ago. Like 2 months ago, one of my coworkers got in an argument with a lady, and she threw her card in her face, brother.
Shit.
If something like that happened to me, actually, well, yeah, no, I stand on this. I'll get over the counter, bro. You're getting in a full Nelson, dog. Until someone comes up to me and can take me off of you, bro.
There's no party is crazy.
Like, huh? Legit smack in the face.
Like, they're arguing. Like, throwing, like...
Yes, like, legit, bow,
in the face. Or, like, kind of like that, or, like a little legit toss. A
throw, like, damn. Like, you threw it, like, a... Whatever his
like
name
a damn
is.
Frisbee.
Yeah, literally.
Oh, nah.
I couldn't do it,
I would've hit that motherfucker. You ain't getting your car back, man. I actually don't know where it is.
I would've snapped it.
What's going on? Accidentally cut it in half.
No, like. Yep. Mm-hmm. In the back.
No, that's wild.
Because yeah. I've been... The racist things just happened at CVS, too.
Oh, I bet.
100%. I just let it off. Laugh at them, you know. I've heard worse. But, dog, I don't know, man. There's certain things. You just can't, like... If you physically, like, try to fight, it's over.
It's done. You're cooked.
Literally.
Nah, bro. Ain't no way, bro.
Just, I don't know.
People, racism
don't know.
These days is just... It's a joke.
It's Yeah, no, it's funny. It's a joke, in my opinion, it's hilarious.
I go to college and I'll hear worse. Like, it's just a joke, bro. What you're saying is not... It's not hurting nobody. Like, calm the fuck down, bro.
At this point, I feel like it might end... Well, I don't know about that. I take that back. Because some people be real, like, racist out there. But
that ass, I thought like, it's gonna end soon.
No, yeah, literally, yeah. But I had experience that I sat down next to me, got up and left. So I was like, damn. Was it my sense? Was I stinking or something? Like, bro,
that is crazy.
But yeah, nah, bro, it's crazy.
I know, and it's so funny because when I was in the moving business, it was I had like went to a house to go move them. Mm-hmm. And they had it was one of those houses. They have a pole with a flag. They had the Confederate flag. Mm-hmm. And then they had the American flag. So I was like, man, the Confederate flag, man, I'm about to walk into some bullshit. But, oh, no. God, these motherfuckers were so nice.
Really?
I swear. Wow. It was like me and then some other, I think it was Larry. He was a darker guy. But they were nice. Mm-hmm. They tipped us and everything. I was like, damn, wow. I guess not so, every Confederate is crazy
yeah,
mad.
Yeah, I have been realizing that recently.
Like, not all of y'all are racist. Like,
I feel like it's dying down a little bit.
It's dying, but those motherfuckers that are not dying, they're holding strong. They're racist, racist.
They're holding on to everybody.
They're holding on to every motherfucking genetic of racism they got, bro.
No way, dog.
They are not letting it die, bro. Yeah. This card says Kamala Harris. From your...
Is that the Biden's replacement?
That's vice president. But yeah, president. If Biden leaves,
I have no idea. Loki. I have no, like...
She's a...
But she's, the one that will, like, replace him.
Mm-hmm.
She's, I don't really know too much about her.
I don't. I haven't been keeping up politics recently.
That's good, bro. That's valid.
I have not. I've been just chilling.
Worrying about yourself.
Literally, at this point.
That's what most of y'all need to do, that y'all be fucking dig deep in politics. Like, y'all need to worry about your motherfucking self, goddamn.
You know, I couldn't speak on behalf of anything politics, so.
That's fair. I don't vote anything, like I said before, and I don't really, whatever happens, like, you know, I can't control that shit, so, like, I'm not gonna try to, like, read hella shit about it to try to...
I just want gas prices to go down.
Exactly.
That's it. That's literally it.
I want life to be cheap, man. Yeah, cheaper, at least. Like, that's I need, it. Like, 2-3 cents down, like, bro, try to live.
At least. I remember it was freaking $1 at one point. I don't know when it was, like, $1.90. It was nice.
Yeah, not no more, bro.
No.
Yeah, and I got my car sucks. That's like 15 miles per gallon. Like, that shit's ass.
Man, I had a Lancer. Brother. Actually, you know, I take that back. Any car I'm in is getting floored when I'm driving it.
Fair.
There's no such thing as miles per gallon for me.
It's fair.
It's just, I just can't do it. Yeah. I can't.
I literally have to fill up like every week. Mm-hmm. I don't even let my shit go under half.
Not every week. I just like every 2-3 days for me.
I'm not going to ride. I guess you do be driving longer.
Yeah, I guess so. But like,
damn.
Every 2-3 days.
That's like, what, $30-$40 a tank?
No, yeah. Damn. But I don't be filling up. I put like 20s in there, but it adds up. Because I know I'm just going to burn it through.
Yeah, you're going to burn through that? That's crazy. You ain't got no goddamn eco mode on your fucking...
Nope. Just
regular. Straight drive.
Yep, that's it. There's nothing special about it or nothing.
Shit.
That is it.
Subaru, up your game, man.
Only thing I like about the Subaru is the steering wheel.
That's it?
That's it. It looks like a nice steering wheel. It has a little paddle shifters. That's it. That's all. I mean, the interior is pretty nice, but like...
Yeah, the paddle shifters would probably look cool as fuck, then.
No, but yeah, it's nice. It's pretty nice. It's nothing like extremely sporty, but it looks good with the steering wheel.
Yeah.
This is
fair, I guess. You only get so much when you get Subaru, bro. You can't expect the world.
I mean, it's a gift, though, so I can't really complain about it too much. It was a gift, and I needed it, so.
Hey.
A car is a car.
If it gets you to point A and point B, that's all that matters.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
You know, it's not. At least it's not rusted and fucking breaking down.
You know what?
Down.
That is valid. That is
at least it's got
valid.
Motherfucking AC and shit.
Yeah, facts. That is 100%
true. You could be, like, in a fucking shit box.
Yeah.
Because
I've definitely been there before, 100%.
Fuck.
Yeah.
Nah, bro, she had a car when I first met her. It was a Nissan Rogue, I think.
Mm-hmm.
Murano. And that shit, like, it was good when I first started like dating her and shit, but then like I felt like as the relationship was going on, like the car was just like getting worse.
Dying, really?
Like get oh, fucked shit. Up. Like you be having people to like fucking jump start us in the parking lot. Ooh. Of the school. We trying to back out of the thing. Her like steering wheel is like locking, like she's driving. That's it, but I gotta like pull from the passenger seat because she can't even pull it. It's so locked.
God.
Shit was
dog.
2006.
Yeah.
She was old.
Bam, you calling my car old? That's crazy.
I had a 2008 Lancer. Thing had almost 300,000 miles
damn.
On it.
That's how mine's
that thing
be.
Was pushing. But recently the what's one of the radio went out. That was the worst thing ever, bro. Just silent rides for the rest
of the time. I
can't
do that.
Just a loud, exhausting silent rides.
I had a speaker because yeah. The car was so loud.
No, the speaker is a different type of ghetto.
Yo, no, facts.
The speaker is a different type of ghetto, bro. No. The JBL was crazy. Yo, that shit didn't even sound right.
That's no facts. Facts.
It sounds so goofy in
there,
hilarious.
Bro. That's hilarious. I'm not gonna lie. That's hilarious.
Dude, on God, I didn't even turn the air down. It's getting kind of hot.
Mm-hmm.
What's number one on your bucket list?
Dang, I don't really have a bucket list like that, to be honest.
Mine's kind of like a bucket list, but I don't really think about it too much.
Like, I say I want a lot of things. Like, I always be like Japan. Off the bat, just, oh.
Japan's on my bucket list. That's number one, going to Japan.
Japan, Netherlands. Yeah, Japan and Netherlands, to be honest. That's the main two places I want to go. I want to get it 180SF imported. Has to be imported. Has to be imported. Other than that, that's house, everything, like the basic stuff, like basic life stuff.
Yeah, hell yeah, that's valid. Yeah, I think mine's just Japan. Like, honestly, like, you know, I think I checked a couple off already. Like, I got a Mustang.
Oh,
really?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Shit, I went to jail.
Oh, yeah. Oh, wow. Like, I have heard about that.
It was like, it wasn't even like, like, it was just like, shit, I guess I gotta do it more than one time, you know what I'm saying? Like,
check out the bucket list, bro.
I was like, yeah, and I was like, I went in there, I was like, yeah, no, this ain't for me.
That's crazy.
This is not for me. Nah. Y'all motherfuckers, for y'all, y'all got this. This ain't for me. Nah. When I knew the most,
I opened
my door and he was handing me my tray, I was like, yeah, this is not for me.
Mm-mm.
This ain't for me. When I got out, I was like, yeah, couldn't never again. I will be the greatest motherfucking citizen I can to stay away from this motherfucking place. Like, yeah.
Body citizen.
Yeah, dead ass. Cause that shit was, that shit's like literally like it reminded me of school. No lie.
Really?
Like, low key. Like,
yo.
But yeah, like, nah, fuck that shit. Other than that, like, I don't really. I want to skydive, but I knew a girl from high school that skydived and she died.
So oh yeah, I heard about that.
One of those like really trying to do
not
that
anymore.
One.
Anymore.
Like yeah, nah.
Yeah.
Maybe like a little, but even like I'm trying to get on the helicopter, but Kobe died on the helicopter. Like, no, oh, facts, can't do shit out crazy. Here now. Like,
yeah, literally,
I can't even
nothing
fucking
safe at all.
Yeah, no. Nah, so I don't even know. I think I want to eat dinner. I've seen these restaurants. I don't know where they are, but it's like a table that you're literally eating dinner in the sky.
Oh,
so like you're sitting in a chair.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about.
I don't
about.
Even know where it is, but you're just sitting in a chair strapped up, and yeah, they're just you're eating dinner
dude,
up there in
that's
the sky.
Crazy.
I don't know if that's Florida or if that's out of country, but
I don't know because
shit would be lit.
Well, my fear is heights. This is it's not actually heights, it's the fear of falling. I guess that's the same.
So you don't fuck with roller coasters?
Oh, I love roller coasters.
Oh, okay, wow.
But the fact it's just free falling, nah, bro.
Same GTA.
No.
You're done.
Yeah, you're finished, bro. You're finished.
Wasted if you
I
hit
know
the
exact day where I got the fear. Boy Scouts back in what? When I was like probably 6 or 7.
Yeah.
We did like a little rock climbing thing. That was like really high. I had to be like at least 50 feet.
Damn.
And the little small little EJ going up the thing, getting stuck up there, that's forgetting crazy. The safety word to get descended. I'm just up there just screaming. Did I just legit just jump off of it? Oh, I mean, we had a little safety vest, but bro, they barely caught me. Because no one was paying attention.
Crazy.
So, like, okay, that's
bro,
that's legit.
That's
day.
How you know you're in a different panic.
No,
you forget the word.
Literally.
That
like,
is
I couldn't think
crazy,
of it.
Bro.
I literally couldn't think of the word. And I was like, okay, bro, I'm stuck. So I just, like, jumped off.
Damn.
Then that's how I got it.
I don't know. Like, heights are weird. Like, when I get up there and I'm looking down, like, it gives me, like, a weird feeling. But I wouldn't say I'm scared. Because I used to rock climb and shit. And it,
oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
It'd be cool and shit. But I don't know. Like, sometimes I'm, like on the swinging chairs, like, at Six Flags and shit.
Yeah,
kinda,
I think like rides
weird.
Are fine to be honest. I think because it's more secure, but just like nothingness and I just look
oh, yeah,
down
like,
somewhere. And
the like, less secure, like the more yeah. fear. Yeah. Sheesh.
Yeah, that's pretty much it though.
Would you bungee much. Jump though?
Oh.
That one's kind of goofy.
Oh,
that's
no,
kinda,
bro. That's
you going down
crazy.
And then fucking get
yeah,
jolted back
crazy.
Up. God.
I don't know about that one, Chief.
I know that one's.
Man.
I want to do it, but like I feel like my fucking neck's gonna get broke. Like that fucking like going down
yo.
Really quick just to fucking bounce
yeah,
right
see,
back
I
up.
I couldn't do it, man. I mean, I feel like it'll be fine, but like I couldn't do it myself.
Yeah, no, we sticking to zip line.
No, if
we're going
zip
from
line
tree
is
to
fine.
Tree
zip line is
type
fine.
Shit. You know, we'll go a little higher on the zip line, but nothing more than that, bro. Dude, I saw some dude on a zip line. Have you seen JJK?
No.
You
JJK.
Don't, yeah. Oh, okay, bro. He was about to have to dip. If you weren't even see JJK, bro. But it's like when Gojo was fighting Toji after Toji killed him. Mm-hmm. And Gojo was like high and shit.
Oh yeah,
bro. It was a guy on a zip line. He was just like free. He was going on the zip line like this. It was just the music, bro. It was so funny, no dude. Way, he was just going on the zip line just like that.
That's wild.
Just getting fucking halted like that. I was like, damn.
That's crazy. What was your? You say okay. I know you're an anime, obviously. What's your top five anime,
All right, we're gonna start off with a Tokyo Ghoul, probably, regardless of what you think. Every single season, I don't give a fuck.
Really? Yeah. I've heard the other seasons are bad after, I think, the first one. I'm just starting Tokyo Ghoul, I'm not gonna lie.
Finish it, bro. Finish it. It's only three seasons. Finish that shit. Mm-hmm. It's good. Tokyo Ghoul, My Hero. I'm a big My Hero. I'm like one of those motherfucking, like, what's it called? How do you say it? Forget it. I'm a deep My Hero fan.
Okay.
Fucking, what else? Probably Attack on Titan.
You know, Attack on Titan was good.
Attack on Titan,
yeah,
great.
It was great, yeah.
Fire. I'm gonna put it, I don't know if you've ever heard of it, because it's kind of like one of those hidden gems. It's called Made in Abyss. Mm-mm. That one's good.
I have not.
And then probably, it's gonna be between Tower of God is taking like the fifth spot right now. It's between Tower of God or Full Metal Alchemist Brotherhood. Mm-hmm. It's between
a lot of people like Brotherhood. A lot of them do.
It's because the other one's trash.
Yeah.
I watched the other one before Brotherhood, and I was like,
yeah,
I felt that's exactly what I did. Like there, like I was like missing out a bunch of stuff.
Yeah.
And someone was like, you need to watch Brotherhood, and it literally ended it. Like it literally showed everything, and it ended the fucking show.
Yeah.
It was a great ending. Like it was probably one of the best endings an anime could have.
Really?
Do you not finish it?
I did not finish it. No. I did not. I started
that. Damn and everything, bro.
I haven't finished.
He gets like a whole family going.
Really?
Yes, dude. Shit. He saves his brother too, I'm pretty sure.
Are you serious?
Yes. Man, but I think he like loses his power or some shit like
that. He probably does. There's always like a little hint, like trade off or something like that.
You having a brat summer?
No. I'm struggling this summer. I'm not gonna lie. This summer semester, I do summer classes, bro. I barely passed these classes.
Damn.
It was bad.
Damn, so what, you got like 2 week break and then you're going right back in?
No, yeah. We go back, that couple weeks till the 12th.
Damn.
So, I mean, I've been doing summer semesters like back to back for the last like
it's just better
2 years.
It gets it done faster?
I changed my major like three times, so I'm kind of behind. I think I'm like caught up a little bit.
Yeah.
But I'm still trying to like get everything situated. Not really situated, but like caught up. Because I'm almost there.
Yeah, I'm not even gonna lie to you. I'm like doing college, but I'm doing it at the slowest pace possible.
No, as long as you're like, doing just, some progress.
Yeah, I'm not trying to like get deep in debt. So like I'll pay.
Yeah.
I'll pay, then I'll like do it, and then I'll probably like wait like a couple months, and then I'll pay again and start up again. Because I'm doing what's it called? Southern New Hampshire University. It's like an online.
Okay.
So it's like pretty chill.
Oh yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay,
so
yeah,
it's like chill and stuff.
I think that's what my sister's doing actually.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I had a coworker of mine put me on it, and she said she graduated from it, and it was cool, and I was like,
that nice sucks. What are you studying?
I think I'm gonna change my shit, because I was gonna do business administration, but I think now I'm gonna do like psychology.
Okay, nice.
So yeah, I think I'm I think I want to be a therapist.
Yeah, my summer's been, man,
just basically school the whole summer.
Yeah, I'm sitting at a desk the entire summer. Just doing work and working at the pharmacy. That's it.
You work at like a CVS?
Mm-hmm.
Up there in the Kennesaw?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Now, pharmacy tech, that's a pretty nice little
job. It is, but it's hectic, obviously.
Yeah.
Sure.
The racist motherfuckers out there trying to get to you, man.
Nah.
No, it's crazy. You ever had, like, a weird, like, working, like, a weird coworker?
No, actually.
Just chill.
It's just a bunch of old people.
Really?
Mm-hmm. My DOS is the one that actually put me on the job, so I'm like, I'm working with a bunch of friends. It's either the friend group or old people. It's one or the other. Yeah, literally.
One or the other. I guess you can't have it all type shit.
No, literally. But hey, it's fine.
That's fair, though.
Fine. It's not horrible.
Yeah.
It's just a lot of standing and filling people's stuff and doing information and stuff like that. So.
Yeah. Sure, you can be fucking out there cutting grass, some shit.
No, literally.
Fucking landscaping.
Oh, shit.
I know. I'd be like,
landscaping?
But that, bro, especially in this heat, boy.
I had a landscaping job before.
Oh, God, you did?
I had to wake up by like 6 o'clock in the morning to cut grass all day. Until like 3, 4, 5 o'clock in the afternoon, bro.
Dude, I'd be going to fucking work, and there'd be fucking landscapers out on these houses. I'm like,
yes, bro, like
every day, bro. You're cutting the grass every fucking day? Ain't no way.
Got a subscription for cutting grass,
I swear, bro.
It was bad.
I know, and they be out there fucking as soon as the sun comes up type shit.
Dog,
even
bro,
before.
The amount of stories I got, bro. I can't even say the stories I was messing them up. My friend Jaden, bro. This man was so goofy, bro. I have so many videos of this man. It's hilarious, bro. This one time he was getting high on the job, and I was taking a video of him. I was zoomed up on him, and he turned around. His eyes were bloodshot red. Bloodshot red. It was hilarious. Grass high is crazy. It was crazy. And this man falling down hills over and everything like that. Bro, it's hilarious.
Bro, it was goofy.
It had to be like the funnest job, too, though. Yeah. Even how like demanding the job was, it was fun as hell.
Oh, yeah. That's how it was for me at Chick-fil-A. Chick-fil-A was like
fucking not work at Chick-fil-A.
Demanding as fuck. It's too but much. The people there were cool as fuck. So like it kind of like balanced it out a little bit.
Yeah.
But then when everybody started, like all the good people started leaving, I was just sitting there like,
oh yeah, no. There's one time I just dipped out because one of my favorite managers left. Like they got fired.
You gotta go.
Bro, I was a delivery driver like in Summit Cookies in Midtown Atlanta.
Damn.
Cars getting messed up and everything, obviously. It's Midtown Atlanta. The amount of tires I went through driving in Atlanta is crazy.
I hate driving through Atlanta.
It's horrible.
It's awful. I'd be like, damn, this is a one-way road. I gotta turn the fucking road.
Bro, the amount of times I turn into oncoming traffic is like, crazy. Oh, shit. And the embarrassment, you have to just do a U-turn in the middle of the road. Bruh,
I know, it's just a different level of embarrassment.
Yeah, I got pulled over one time for doing it too. It was on camp. It was on the Georgia Tech campus. Like I pulled into the wrong way. There was two cops. One came up behind me. One came in front of me. Like legit cut me off. Wild. I was like, bro, I'm just trying to deliver some stuff. And like, dog, I understand. Cause I think they thought I was drunk or something, bro. Cause there was a bunch of parties going around, everything like that, and saw me turn on the wrong side of the road or something.
I'm just like, bro, I don't be like, here.
Go
every
get
day.
This man or something.
Like I don't like, be on these roads every day. Facts. Like
that's crazy. Nah, bro, I couldn't. But. Once she left, I headed out the next day. Never come back. Because it was so lean, but the new one that came in was so strict. Like, I was no way I was going to stay hired for like longer. Because the way I was.
Cut you off.
Yeah, cut me off.
That's instantly. Wild.
The way I'd be doing things over there, bro, I was being too comfy. It was too comfy. Arriving at work. There's one time I went to work 2 hours late.
Damn.
She said, okay, no worries at all.
Okay. Say less.
No, literally, that's it. Hey.
But, shit, whatever you say, manager.
But yeah, but. Yeah.
This is a long ass question, don't lie.
Okay.
If aliens came on Earth, who are you choosing to be the spokesperson for humanity?
Oh man.
Ryan Reynolds.
Oh hell yeah.
I feel like Ryan Reynolds.
Yes, bro.
He might lock
He'll
in there.
He'll do his justice. He'll do the justice,
might, he
bro.
He might save us, bro.
Yeah.
He might.
I completely agree.
Ryan Reynolds might do the thing, and he might save us from fucking
yeah, 100%. Death. 100%.
Like, I don't even know who else, bro. Anyone else might fucking might kill us all.
Man. No, facts. Yeah. 100% is Ryan Reynolds. Sure. 100%.
It's valid.
Mm-hmm. If you would... Okay. Your favorite, all-time favorite anime character. All the animes. You can pick anything. All-time favorite.
My favorite character. Mm-hmm. Shit.
I think you know already.
His?
Yours. Or mine. I mean, you made it.
Oh, you're right. Mm-hmm. You're so right.
That's crazy, bro. I gotta show you my tat, dude.
Your tat?
Yeah, I got a tat of that character.
Are you serious?
Yeah. It's Hisoka, right?
No.
I'm thinking of someone else.
Disappointed.
I was about to say if you said Hisoka. Oh, it's Madara.
Yeah.
Shit, Madara's your favorite character of all time?
He is goated, bro. I don't care anyone says.
Probably Aaron. Not even lie. Aaron Yeager.
Mm-hmm. That's valid.
I literally told her I want to name my child Aaron.
Are you serious?
She won't let me because her mom, her stepmom's name Aaron.
Oh, that's valid though. That's valid.
I'm like, bro, it's E-R-E-N. Hers is E-R-I-N. Like, it's a difference, bro.
Nah, I don't know, man.
I don't want her to think that she had like a ability that our child is named after. I don't want that to be.
Yeah, no, that's valid. That's actually valid. I'm not gonna lie.
Shit, I don't know. If it's not Aaron, it's probably like Ken Kaneki from Tokyo Ghoul.
Oh, I just like correlated that to the baby name. And I'm like,
oh,
no. My dad's name?
Are you serious? No way. That's wild. What the fuck?
I'm about to name my son Deku or some shit.
That's like, crazy.
But yeah, like, yo.
Yo, no way.
Yeah, probably like Aaron.
Okay.
Because
okay,
I feel like I say Naruto, but he's just so like, everyone gonna say that shit. Well, Naruto's definitely I feel
like
up there.
People like Sasuke more than Naruto.
Yeah.
I feel like.
Yeah, I'm more of a Naruto guy. I think Sasuke's cool, but no, I just like I like Naruto's like the way he was built up.
Yeah.
I like his character development was like there. It's pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
Sasuke's cool too, but like he's always a badass, you know. Yeah. Naruto was a bitch.
I mean,
he was a bitch. Painting the Hokages and shit.
Okay, yeah,
running
yeah,
from teachers
yeah,
and shit.
You're right.
Bro, now he stood on business though when, you know, the first I think it was like first when he was stealing the scroll. He still he was doing my business. Mm-hmm. He's like, you ain't gonna fuck with my teacher, bro. You ain't gonna fuck with my teacher. I was like, okay.
Yo. Okay. Like, nah, bro, that's true.
But yeah, Naruto's definitely up there, but he's like one of those, like, he's like up there with Dragon Ball. Rest in peace.
Mm-hmm,
so, like, Dragon Ball is like one of my, like, I won't even put him in my top five because he's like already, like, he's a godfather.
Yeah, thing is, don't kill me. I grew up on Naruto. I haven't watched Where? One Piece. I haven't watched Dragon Ball. I haven't watched like I haven't watched the ones. I know.
You're locked in, bro. I used to be just like you, bro. You need to get on One Piece, man.
I don't know, man. That's another 1,000.
I don't give a damn how long it is, bro. I caught up. I saw Gear 5 in fucking live, bro.
Yo,
like,
no.
Yeah, no. One Piece, it was like one of my coworkers that got me onto it. And he was like, bro, you have to watch it. And I was like, you know what? Fuck it. And I watched it and I was like, okay. Takes a little slow, but if you're dedicated, you're going to like it.
I mean, I've watched every single episode.
Dragon Ball, I have not watched everything of Dragon Ball. I think I've watched like when he was little and that's it.
I only watched it back in like in the day where they're actually
when it was actually like
it.
Dropping it mm-hmm. and like coming out on TV. But yeah. Yeah, other than that, like
because my cousin we used to put Beyblades all the time. We would just watch like Dragon Ball in the background. Yeah. That's how it was.
Dude, I heard they were gonna add Beyblade to the Olympics.
Huh? Beyblades to the Olympics? What?
I swear I heard that from somewhere.
That's crazy. Yes, no, bro. What do you mean? Just rip it and just let it go?
Yeah, just like the show,
There's
bro.
No shot, dog.
Let it rip. No way. Yes, sir, bro. Shit. You gonna catch me with the gloves? You gonna catch me fucking
the fucking armor?
A whole fucking sleeve for that shit.
Dog, that's crazy.
Yeah, no, I don't know if it's real. I think it was a joke, but
it had to be. There's no way.
Yeah, they had like Snoop Dogg like lighting torches at the fucking. He was like representing America.
Brother. That's crazy. That's crazy. Oh my God.
I'm like commentating on like some of them too, like the horses.
Really? Snoop? Bro, yeah, what is this man doing?
He's on side quests, bro. Bro, it's everywhere. Dude, like literally, bro, literally he teased us. He was like, all right, I'm going to quit smoking. And then drops an ad for like a smoker.
I do remember that one.
I was like, okay, brother.
I do remember that.
He has an official Olympic pin and it's him blowing out the O's.
That's crazy.
That's actually fire, no lie.
Oh my God.
That's actually a fire little pin.
That's actually cool, I'm not going to lie.
Now, Snoop Dogg low-key done everything. And he's still doing everything as we speak.
He's doing everything he can.
Damn.
He's trying to get every side quest done.
Not facts.
That's hilarious. Oh my God. All
right. If you had the attention of the world for like 20 seconds, what would you say? Don't say it yet. Just think on it. I'm going to outro you and then you're going to say it to your camera. 20 seconds. Oh, what would you say if you had the entire world's attention? You can say whatever you want. It don't matter. People promote. People say thoughtful messages, heartfelt messages, hateful messages.
Dog.
But anyways, this wraps up, I'm pretty sure episode 22 of the Abyss podcast with our special beautiful guest here, EJ. Had a great time with him. If y'all enjoyed, make sure to leave a like, and if y'all want more, subscribe, and EJ's gonna exit us on out of here.
I came into it, bro. I'm trying to blame, bro. I had 20 seconds. I couldn't do it.
Bro, I mean, it don't matter, bro. Literally can be anything, whatever you want. I love you, mom. Like some shit. It don't matter,
go.
Bro.
There you go.
Bro,
there you go. I love you, mom. Appreciate everything you've done. I appreciate it. That's all I could say. Yeah.